that I didn't even think about. Check this out.
Fixed many fights. You know, I used to go to Costa Rica with an envelope from Top Rank Boxing to Gino Da Vinci. And he had 2bet.net and goldenpalace.com. And I would go to Costa Rica and I'd give him the envelope.
So did y'all hear what this man said? I don't know if y'all heard that, but he said he would give the envelope to whatever the man name he said, Torres or something, because he had two betting websites. He had two betting websites. So not only are these people fixing the fights, so they know who gonna win, they got the betting websites also. Listen, that's a whole nother level. This is a whole nother level, y'all. This is deeper than what we were actually thinking. We thinking, oh, they want to win so Vegas can win. Vegas? These people making up their own betting websites and fixing the fights. And then you keep hearing, oh, Top Rank have the best quote-unquote matchmakers in boxing. They got the best quote-unquote matchmakers in boxing. So what I've learned is you have to pay attention to the verbiage and the words being used. You can't just take them for surface level. So we've been hearing they got the best matchmakers in boxing. On the surface level, you think, oh, they're good at matching people up that you can beat. No, 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 no. It's way deeper than that. They're good at hiring people you can beat. Top Rank. Top Rank and Bob Arum. They're hiring people for you to beat. People that's not even boxers. People that don't even fight. Or they're going around paying people to lose. That's matchmaking. So listen to the code. These people speak in code. That's why you have to, they double speak. Politicians do it too. They double speak. You think they talking about one thing and they're really talking about a whole nother other subject. And you just shaking your head, smiling in agreeance because you thinking they know what they talking about. Because you don't really understand how deep the corruption can go in boxing. So you keep hearing, and I used to be like, what does that mean? Are they the only people with matchmakers? What does that even mean? Because if you think about it, is matchmaking is still kind of like a little questionable. Like, so you would see three fighters and be like, nah, you can't fight him. His style will beat you. Or you can't fight him. His style will beat you. I get his style makes fights. You want to build your fighter. You want to do this. You want to do that. I get it. But listening to Joey say that they hired him. And then now you sit back and you think, man, they do say they got the best matchmakers. They got the best matchmakers. Is this what they do? Is this what they mean? Are they really hiring people to lose in boxing matches? And now it makes sense to me. This is why I do not like Top Rank cards, really. Every now and then, Top Rank will put on a good card, and I'll be like, man, that's like probably one of the best Top Rank. Every time I see a good Top Rank card, it's one of the best Top Rank cards I've ever seen. And I've seen some horrible Top Rank cards. Hey, let me...
If you like this clip and you want to watch another one, click right here. If you want to watch the entire live, click right here. Make sure you punch that like and subscribe button and let me know and drop it below your 2 cents about the video you just heard. I'm Jay, and stay tuned for our 2 cents in the next video. Peace.